door locked, good and tight. I'm not worried, Muzzles.
To do, have us thrown off the train?
Well, if it isn't Muscles Malloy, to what do I owe this great pleasure?
Get over there, Blackie. This is not a lollipop in my pocket.
I don't apologize. I'm on a diet anyway.
What are you doing on this train?
Doing? Why, I missed a slow boat to China, and this was the next best thing I could get.
Can the comedy. Boss wants to know why you're on this particular train.
Well, as long as you put it that way, you can tell Tony Warren it's none of his business.
Just your business, huh? And Steve Crane's.
Steve Crane? Who's he?
The guy who hired you. Keep talking. You won't look very good as a corpse.
You hear that, Whitey? You better protect me.
This guy's tough. Get him.
I don't know what the pitch is, Muscles, but don't pull it again. Now get out. Whitey, you know, I think I better go look up Muscles' boss and see what this is all about. You met him once, remember? Tony Warren, the big gambler. And will you be a good boy? Not make any noise? Here. Give me your ball. Catch it. You stay here and don't make any noise. You're a good boy.
Boss. Boss, it's me. Muscles, open up. Hey, conductor. Come here, quick.
What's the trouble?
Mr. Warren, my boss, is in there. He doesn't answer. I'm worried.
Well, he's probably fast asleep.
He don't sleep that sound. Open that door.
Get a screwdriver, Sam.
Why a screwdriver? Why not a key?
See that plate?
Yeah.
It has to come off first. It's the only way we can get to the inside lock.
Here, let me have it.
Hey, what goes on here?
We don't know yet.
All right, open up. Get on my way. Conductor, look.
Clear out, please. Here, keep both away from here. Come on, please. Go.
He's dead. It's a good thing for you, Blackie, that you're in your compartment.
Fine bodyguard you turned out to be. You know, you might lose your card in the gunman's local.
Inspector Faraday. This is the medical examiner.
I'm glad you're here. I've ordered all passengers to remain on board until they are cleared.
Good. Where's the body?
In here.
Tony Warren. This doesn't surprise me. He's all yours, Doc. Tell me, what do you know about this?
Well, I was walking along the hallway.
It doesn't make sense. No fingerprints on the knife. Everything locked up tight as a drum. How did the killer get out of the compartment?
That's a very good question. And brilliantly put, Faraday.
Blackie! What are you doing here?
Just resting. I'm tired. I stayed up too late last night reading detective stories.
Where did you get on this train?
It's been so long ago, I've forgotten. What difference does it make to you where I got off?
Now, look here, Blackie. I asked a question and I demand an answer.
He was present when we opened this compartment door.
Well, you don't say.
Wait for me outside. I'll be right out. Sit down, Blackie.
Thank you, Inspector. Now, tell me.
What do you know about this murder?
Why, Inspector, you know it isn't ethical to reveal trade secrets. Solve your own murders.
If you know what's good for you, you'll talk.
Well, I guess I might as well confess. I'd never be able to fool you anyway.
No.
I did it.
What? You did it?
Yeah. Surprised?
No. Nothing you do surprises me anymore. Keep talking.
Well, after the job was done, I looked around the room to make sure that everything was in order.
Yeah.
And then I went to the door, and I locked it from the inside. And then...
Go on.
Oh, yes. I went over here to the body. I made sure that I left no fingerprints on the knife.
Keep going.
No, don't rush me. I'm trying to remember. Oh, yes. I went to the door. Real quiet. And I crawled out through the keyhole.
That was very, very funny.
Did you really like it?
Look here, Blackie. If you think you can make a fool out of me, you're mistaken. That's done it. You're under arrest.
Under arrest?
Yes.
What for?
For violating the law, prohibiting dogs on passenger cars.
But I didn't violate the law.
Whitey did.
You can't arrest him. Whitey can't read. But he can stand on his hind legs and do lots of other tricks. You want to see him?
No.
Well, you don't have to be so rude about it.
Look, Blackie, stop the clowning and tell me what you know about this, will you, please?
No, Inspector, you're not going to need my help in this case. It's probably very simple. You see, Tony Warren was the kind of a gambler who'd take a bet on anything. So he probably bet someone it was impossible to get into his compartment, kill him with a knife, lock the door on the inside, and then leave. Now, all you have to do is find the fellow who collected the bet, and you've got your man.
But, Blackie!
Sorry to leave you like this, Inspector, but Mary's waiting for me. Come on, Whitey.
Bring in the other passengers a couple at a time.
Hello, Mary. How's my favorite girlfriend?
Your favorite girlfriend? Don't tell me you have more than one now. Has he, Whitey? Come on now, tell me the truth.
Whitey, you're a pal and a scholar, and just for this, you get an extra large ball. You get my wire in time to pick up my car?
Mm-hmm, it's over in the parking lot. And, by the way, that completes my end of the deal.
Deal?
Mm-hmm. Your telegram. It said, quote, meet me Union Station with my car. Stop. We'll take you to lunch. Unquote.
All right, gorgeous. I won't back out on you.
You're on, my wandering Lockenbach. A luncheon we will go.
I recognize this place as not being one of our favorite restaurants. Why are you stopping here?
Not to eat, but I've got to see a guy for a few minutes.
But, Blackie, your telegram...
I know, gorgeous, but a man can't say everything in 10 words.
Hello, Smokey. What'll it be, gents?
Black deuce.
I'll pass, too. Here. Thanks.
Know anyone called Steve Crane?
I've heard of him.
Who is he?
Bookie. A high roller. Got a high-stepping babe. Good-looking. But expensive.
What's his connection with Tony Warren?
You mean the late Tony Warren? Tony was bankroll on him.
I see. What's the word on the killing?
The Great Plains hot.
No, who did it?
Nope.
Got any ideas?
Yeah. Well, what do you know? A black deuce. Steve's been tapping the till on long shots.
Oh, I see. He's with the crooked partner. Know where I can find him?
Got a pencil?
Yeah.
Thanks, Cokie.
I'm sure I smell a mouse, but I am sure I don't smell any food around here.
Well, you see, Mary,
I know. Don't tell me. You'll be back in just 1 minute.
That's why I love you, baby. You read my every thought.
I don't know what you're handing me, Blackie, but it's not a menu.
On the level, baby. This is important. I'll be out in 10 minutes, so help me.
I'll give you 5, and if you're not out by then, I'm coming in after you.
It's a deal.
To have a little talk with you.
About what?
Homicide. Say, this is a nice place you've got here.
Whatever you've got to say, say it and get out.
Now, let's not be so hasty. After all, murder is rather a delicate subject.
Just what are you talking about?
Tony Warren? He was murdered last night.
Warren murdered?
Well, don't act so surprised. He was on his way down here to settle his accounts with you when you had him sidetracked. As a matter of fact, you were shortchanging him on the book.
You're talking through your hat. I don't know anything about it. And what if he was bankrolling me? It'll take more... Nice work, Slugs. Take him down to the basement.
Shall I give him the treatment?
Tonight. It'll be safer.
Exciting, isn't it? We'll continue with Boston Blackie in just a moment.
Whitey, are we mice or are we mad?
What?
We're mad. Come on. Come on, Whitey. Come on. Sit, Whitey, sit. I left the elevator operator where he went. Whitey, I guess we'll have to go down to the basement and wake him up. Come on, Whitey. Come on. Come on. Oh! 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 That's Blackie's hat.
That made that noise, huh?
Oh.
you doing here?
Getting you loose so you can take me to lunch.
Oh, my head. Is it still there?
Seems to be. Come on, Blackie. Let's get out of here.
Oh, my head.
What happened?
Well, Mary, there was a murder on the train last night. And I'm sure a man upstairs by the name of Steve Crane had something to do with it.
You thought you could leave me out of it. Serves you right for not taking me along as your bodyguard.
This is one for the books. Man is killed, stabbed by a knife. Door's locked from the inside and the window's sealed. And yet the killer gets out again.
I'll buy you a nice crystal ball. You won't have to guess. Come on. Come on, Whitey.
But I tell you, Mary, this doesn't make sense. What's wrong? Where'd he come from?
Well, that's the same man I just hit over the head with that same pipe.
You?
Sure. I had Whitey entice him behind the crates and then bopped him once.
Oh, Mary, you're wonderful. Say, I'll bet that's the character that blackjacked me when I was up in Crane's apartment.
That I don't believe. No blackjack would have any effect on that hard head of yours. It probably served your cocktail with knockout drops.
Maybe, but I didn't get this bump on my head from... What did you say? Knockout drops. Well, Mary, that's it. Jim, come on, let's go.
Hey, where are we going?
Oh, baby, park the car for me.
You were his bodyguard, Muscles. You must have an idea who killed Tony.
I have, copper. And I'll take care of him my own way.
Now, look here, Muscles. I'll give you one
Faraday,
more chance.
Faraday! I want to talk to you right away.
But
come on
in.
Come on, it's important.
You stay put.
I got news for you about Tony.
Here?
How do you think he was killed?
How do I think he was killed? You're trying to pull my leg. He had a knife in his back that long. And you're asking me how I think he was killed? I'll let you in on a little secret. That knife was just an ornament. Tony was kicked to death by a horse.
Oh, he was killed by a knife, all right. But the killer used knockout drops before he did it.
Knockout drops? Now I've heard everything. I suppose he didn't want Tony to feel the pain, eh? Why don't you go home and soak your head?
Listen, Faraday. If you've got a brain in your head, you'll get over to the Summerhill apartment right away. See a man by the name of Steve Crane in apartment 312 and hold him until I get there.
What are you trying to do? Give me orders?
No, just a red-hot tip like I did in the Williams murder, remember?
Oh.
But have it your own way if you want to go back to pounding a beat and see if I care.
I'll do it. But if this turns out to be a lemon, I'll crucify you, so help me. Yes.
And Faraday, listen. There's another character in the basement, or he may be in Crane's apartment. You better hold him, too. First assault and battery.
Good.
Okay, Muscles, you can go now.
Yeah, it's high time.
What do you want?
Muscles, you don't seem very pleased to see me.
The less I see of you, the better I like it. Not beat it.
You're not being very hospitable. Considering all the trouble I went to find out who killed Tony, aren't you interested in knowing who it was?
Sure I am. Who was it?
You.
Me?
Yes, you. And the nerve of you last night warning me to lay off of Tony. Some cover-up.
Stop making with the jokes. I don't like it.
No.
You were there when the conductor opened the door to Tony's compartment. How could I have killed him?
That's one little detail I haven't figured out yet. But I will. Cigarette.
Keep him.
Be seeing him. Obliging, Muscles.
Whether you were a knife thrower was the little detail I hadn't figured out. Let me have your gun.
Blackie, I was... Blackie, I'm sorry.
Don't worry, Mary. He won't get far.
Little talk on the way to headquarters.
I'll make it hot before this is over, Faraday. You haven't got a thing on me.
Oh, no? Muscles just sang good and loud.
But what did Muscles have to do with it?
He did the job. Crane here put the finger on Tony.
Ridiculous.
You mean to tell me that Muscles did it?
Yeah. I just dropped him off at headquarters on the way over here. Pretty clever the way you had that job done, Crane.
Would you mind telling me how he had it done?
Of course not. First he hired Muscles to double-cross his boss. Then Muscles slipped some knockout drops into Tony's medicine so he wouldn't answer the door when he pounded on it. Here's the bottle.
But Tony was dead when the conductor unlocked the door. He had a big knife in his back, remember?
That's exactly what Muscles wanted us to believe.
You mean he wasn't dead?
No, he was just knocked out. Tony wasn't killed until after the door was unlocked. By a knife thrown from the doorway a split second after the door was opened.
But Muscles was Tony's bodyguard.
The killer had to be the first one in the compartment, Muscles. And he had to be a Lulu of a knife thrower, Muscles again. Right, Crane?
Blackie, I called back.
Crane, not so fast. When you leave here, it won't be alone. Get him out of here.
Mary. You timed it perfect.
Whitey, come on, boy.
Oh, and you were swell, too. And just for this, you get the biggest bone in Los Angeles. And Inspector Faraday is going to buy it for you.
Yeah, that I will, Whitey, that I will.
Blackie, can I have one, too? With a big steak wrapped around it? I'm hungry.